Welcome to Georgia Highlands College Math 97 and Math 99 video tutorials. In this video segment, we'll answer the question, what is the zero product principle? Well, the zero product principle is a very simple principle, yet very powerful when it comes to solving polynomial equations. It simply states that if I'm multiplying factors together, so if I'm creating a product A times B, and that product is equal to zero, the only way for that to occur is if either A is zero or B is zero. So simply stated, if you're multiplying two things together that make zero, then you had to be multiplying with zero. So let's take a closer look at the property itself and a couple of examples. Okay, so at the top of the screen here, I just have stated the zero product principle in phrased words here. So if the product of two algebraic expressions is zero, then at least one of the factors had to be zero. In other words, if A times B equals zero, then A equals zero or B equals zero. So let's take a look at this example here. I have two factors being multiplied equaling zero. I have a factor of x plus 3, and I have a factor of x minus 4. And you might recognize that it follows that same sort of form as something being multiplied with something else equaling zero. So we're set up to use our zero product principle. Now to apply this principle, we're going to state that one of these factors had to at least be zero. So I simply write that out as the factor x plus 3 either had to equal zero for me to be able to multiply these two things together to make zero, or x minus 4 had to equal zero. So right here, I'm applying the zero product principle by setting each of those factors equal to zero. Then it's easy from here, you simply solve for x in each of these equations. So here I would subtract 3 from both sides and find that x is equal to negative 3. And in the other equation, I would add 4 to both sides and get that x is equal to 4. Now, we're talking about an equation here, so when you find solutions to an equation, you should be able to plug them back into the original equation and have it equal out with a true statement. So let's check each of these, negative 3 and 4, and see that they are actually solutions to the equation x plus 3 times x minus 4 equals 0. So I'll just rewrite my equation to begin with before I plug in my value. And in this first one, I'm going to plug in the value negative 3 wherever I see x. So I have negative 3 plus 3 times negative 3 minus 4. And I'm going to see if that equals 0. Negative 3 plus 3 is 0. Negative 3 minus 4 is negative 7. And 0 times anything is just 0. So sure enough, I have a true statement there, meaning that x equals negative 3 is a solution to my equation. And now checking positive 4 by plugging in. So I'll start by just rewriting my original equation, x plus 3 times x minus 4 equals 0. And next I'll plug 4 in for x in both of the factors. And that gives me 4 plus 3, giving 7, and 4 minus 4, which is 0. And certainly 7 times 0 is 0, making positive 4 a solution as well. So we have verified that using our zero product principle, we find two solutions to this equation, negative 3 and positive 4, which can either be written as x equals negative 3, comma, 4, or you can write them as a set, negative 3 and 4. Sometimes it's difficult to draw those braces like that. A lot of my students just draw squigglies, and I tell them I know what that means. There's one other thing I'd like to point out before we end this video segment, and that is the fact that this particular equation came from the polynomial equation x squared minus x minus 12 equals 0. So we have that standard form, and I just got that by multiplying x plus 3 times x minus 4. So you can see that that equation actually started out as a quadratic equation in standard form. Just to point out, my a would be positive 1 here, my b would be negative 1, and my c is negative 12. So this should give you a little bit of insight into what we're about to move into, which is solving quadratic equations. We use factoring and applying the zero product principle to do so. I hope that this has been helpful for you in understanding the zero product principle. Once again, it's a simple principle, but it's very powerful. All it states that is that if you're multiplying factors together and equaling 0, then one of those factors had to be 0. And we use this in solving quadratic equations by setting each of those linear factors up to equaling 0 and then solving for it. If you have any other questions about the zero product principle, please feel free to contact your Highlands instructor. Thank you.